Welcome to Programming Hunk, and I am Pushpendra.
In this tutorial, we are discussing the Fibonacci series. So this is the actual representation of Fibonacci series. We can define a Fibonacci number in the series as the sum of its previous two Fibonacci numbers. We can write a recursive method here to calculate the Fibonacci number recursively. For this, we first write the base conditions here, which are: if num is equal to 0, then we will return 0, and if the num is equal to 1, then we will return 1. Otherwise, we will return the sum of two previous Fibonacci numbers. For this, we can again call Fibonacci n minus 2 plus Fibonacci n minus 1 recursively inside the Fibonacci method itself. If we want to print any Fibonacci number, for this we have to create the object of data recursion class, as I have created here. If I want to print the Fibonacci number at position 9, then I can run this program like this. But if we want to print the series up to some given value, like I'm using 11 here, and print all the Fibonacci numbers till the value is n, then I can write them in a loop, in a for loop. I'm writing here. On compiling this program, you can see all of the series. If you want to see them in a single line, then we can use here slash t and run this program like this. You can see here all of the elements in the Fibonacci series.
Thank you for watching. Like, share, subscribe and comment.